Looking at this problem, let's go with our formula. This is similar to the last one. You have the principal, you have 1 plus your rate, but the difference is now you're looking at how often it's compounded. And in this example, it's compounded quarterly. So the number of compounding, and then you're going to have the number of compounding times. The time, the number of years. So now, that's the formula that you'll work with. So going into this first problem here, what we have is we have $5,000. You've got 1 plus 0.035. That's your rate. And then it's going to go over 4 because it's quarterly. And then that 4 will appear again in your time. They want to know what's the CD going to be worth in 3 years. So that's all the plug-in. Now you need to do the calculation. So let's go back and let's simplify this. You can do this all out left to right. You can choose your favorite piece first. But my suggestion, rewrite it. So you got the $5,000. When you divide this out here and you add 1 to it, that whole parenthesis is worth 1.00875. And then I would multiply those two numbers right away. I wouldn't even think twice about it, or else you may lose the answer. If you go from left to right, bring it up to the fourth power and then go times 3. So now, all you need to deal with is that right there. Now you can go 5,000 times this number in parentheses to the 12th power. Or you can just, if you have the caret or the x to the y key, you're going to punch in this number, 1.00875 to the 12th, and then times 5,000. And your final answer comes out to 5,551.02. Now, let's look at that same problem, but we're going to change it, because now the next part of the question asks, in 6 years, what will everything be worth? So now, let's look at this. We still have the $5,000. 1 plus the 0.035 over 4. But now what you're saying, I'm running out of space here in the corner, we're saying we've got same quarterly, but now we've got 6 years. So we're going to have to multiply it by 6 instead of 3. So my next line becomes 5,000, same parenthesis, 1.00875, and 4 times 6 is 24. Multiply that all out, and for a final answer, what you get is you get $6,162.76. Again, go with the common sense. You're starting with 5,000. On both of these, you have to end up with more than 5,000. You're not going to double the price. You're not going to go from 5,000 to 7,000. That's going to take a while for that to happen. So kind of get a ballpark, but prior to even starting the problem.